Good afternoon, class. Our topic today is about civil society and non-governmental organizations. Okay. So, civil society is a state or situation of people living in particular community or nation, having shared interests, values, and purpose, getting benefit to have rights of individuals, enjoying liberty, and to have resources to develop personal potential. Okay, so maunay atong that is civil society. So, the London School of Economics Center for Civil Society's working definition is illustrative of what is civil society. So, according to them, civil society refers to the arena of uncoerced collective action around shared interests, purposes, and values. Civil society commonly embraces a diversity of spaces, actors, and institutional forms, varying in their degree of formality, autonomy, and power. Civil societies are often populated by organizations such as registered charities, development, non-governmental organizations, community groups, women's organizations, faith-based organizations, professional associations, trade unions, self-help groups, social movements, business associations, coalitions, and advocacy groups. So in short, class, civil society is the aggregate of non-governmental organizations and institutions that manifest will and interest of the citizens. Okay, so that's the short meaning of civil society, no? Now, this is a remark, the symposium in a cosmopolitan society, human safety and rights in plural and peaceful societies. His Highness the Aga Khan on February 12, 2006 at University of Évora, Portugal. So, government alone do not make democracy work. Private initiative is also essential, including a vital role of those institutions which are collectively described as civil society. So again, ha, when we talk of civil society, this is an aggregate of all the non-governmental organizations. The basis for civil society class in the Philippines comes from the Filipino concepts of pakikipagkapwa. Okay, so, and this pakikipagkapwa is holistic interaction with others and the kapwa, which is our shared inner self. No? Voluntary assistance of charity connotes for Filipinos an equal status between the provider of assistance and the recipient, which is embodied in the terms damayan, also meaning assistance of peers in periods of crisis, and pagtutulungan, the mutual self-help. So the Western Union of, the Western notion of kawanggawa or charity may have been introduced to the Philippines by Catholic missionaries. So sila na ang nag-introduce, ang mga Catholic missionaries ang nag introduce aning charity or mga charity words, no? Okay. Postmodern history, the element of civil society was developed during 1980s in Europe by the political opposition. So later in 1990s, emergence of non-government organizations and new social movement gave birth on global scale. So dili pa jud ni ingon tugay kaayo ni civil society class, no? Now, Taking the definition mentioned, we derive three major elements of society. So first, we have diversity. Second, non-government organizations. And third is democracy. Okay, so these are the elements of civil society. Again, we have first diversity, we have non-government organizations, and we have democracy. Now, let's talk about diversity first. So diversity is multi-formality. Okay, so it means understanding that each individual is unique and recognizing our individual differences. So unique ta, and we have our own differences. This can be along the dimensions of race, ethnicity, gender, sexual orientation, socioeconomic status, age, physical abilities, religious beliefs, political beliefs, or other ideologies. Now, diversity class is the exploration of these differences in a safe, positive, and nurturing environment. It is about understanding each other and moving beyond simple tolerance to embracing and celebrating the rich dimensions of diversity contained within each individual. Kay lahi-lahi man ta nga ano, lahi-lahi man ta og capacity, lahi-lahi ta og pagsabot, no? So diverse. Even kitang mga Pilipino, we also have diverse culture, no? Even sa family, lahi-lahi gihapon ta, diverse gihapon ta. Walay magkapareha. Then we have the second element is non-government organization. So an NGO. So I know you have heard this term already. No, dili ni foreign sa inyo ni term nga NGO or non-governmental organization. It's a legally constituted organization created by private organizations or people with no participation or representation of any government. So hence the term non-government. No, so in the cases in which NGOs are funded totally or partially by governments, the NGO maintains its non-governmental status insofar as it excludes government representatives from membership in the organization. So there are other NGOs class nga ang nag-fund nila totally or either partially, gi-fund gyapon sila sa government, pero gina-exclude nila ang government, no, on representations or what dili sila nag-fund but dili sila member ana na certain non-government organization. Then we have the third element, which is democracy. Okay, so when we say democracy, this is means that everyone has the right to say. Okay, so we have each of us, no, as a being, as a human being, or as a person, we have our individual right. Okay, so we have the right to say, and we have the right to liberty. Now, democracy, this is literally mean rule by the people. Okay, so this is a system where the control of an organization or group is by the majority of its members. The members have the authority to deliberate and decide anything pertaining to the organization, and of course can choose officers that would govern them. So that is the essence of democracy. Okay, civil society organization. Okay, so I know this is also familiar to you, the term CSO, or again, civil society organization. Now, a civil society organization is a group of people which operates in the community in a way that is distinct from both government and business. So they operate in the community, but lahi siya sa ug unsa mag-operate ang government or ang business. Now, civil society organizations can be defined to include all non-market and non-state organizations outside of the family in which people organize themselves to pursue shared interests in the public domain. So, meaning to say public with public interest, anything in the community that concerns with public interest na asi or ma-include or ma-define na to si CSO. Okay. So, types and or forms of CSOs or civil society organizations. Now, so we have non-government organizations. Okay. Again, NGO, CCNGO, pwede siya international and pwede po siya national. Now, we have for international and national NGOs, we have community-based organizations or CBOs. Okay, we have social movements. Okay, so we have professional organizations. We have women's group. Okay, so we have foundations. We have independent research institutes. We have faith-based organizations or kanang mga organizations nga based sa ilahang religion or sa ilang faith or sa ilang sect. We have people's organizations or kana atong gitawag o PO. And then we have social movements. And of course, we have labor unions. Okay, kanan. Sa work-related na organization. We also have youth-led organizations. So those organizations nga ang leader or ang nagpadagan is ang mga youth. Okay. Now, civil society's class can be NGOs that have organized. Okay. Do not be confused with civil society organization and NGO, ha? Okay. NGOs that have an organized structure or activity and are typically registered in entities and groups. Online groups and activities including social media communities that can be organized but do not necessarily have physical, legal, or financial structures. Or social movements of collective actions or identity, which can be online or physical. And religious leaders, faith communities, and faith-based organizations. Now, we also have labor unions and labor organizations representing workers. We have social entrepreneurs employing innovative and market-oriented approaches for social and environmental outcomes. We have grassroots associations and activities at local level. So when we say grassroots organizations, these are primarily made up of civilians advocating a cause to spur change at local, national, or international levels. Okay. Then we have cooperative owned and democratically controlled by their members. Okay, so let's talk about the role of CSOs. Okay, so first we have watchdog. Okay, so it holds the institutions or any institutions to account, promote transparency and accountability. Okay, so an example of this. A certain CSO or civil society organization that serves as our watchdog is the GWatch. No, so manay atong, I don't know if you heard GWatch, but mana sila nagsilbi na sila nga watchdog. Okay. Then we have advocate. So it raises awareness of societal issues and challenges and advocating for change. Okay. Then service provider, some CSOs also is a service provider, so delivering services to meet societal needs such as education, food, and security. And then we have experts, so they serve as expert, bringing unique knowledge and experience to shape policy and strategy and identifying and building solutions. Then we have citizenship champion. So a CSO can be a citizenship champion. So they encourage citizen engagement and support the rights of citizens. Then solidarity supporter. So they promote fundamental and universal values. Now, of course, there are challenges, no, nga ma-face sa different CSOs. So the findings showed that despite the contribution of CSOs, they are still faced with some constraints such as fund, no. So maglisod sila pangita o budget or fund. Then of course, corruption, government interference, identity, lack of cohesion in the performance of their duty. Okay. Now, what is the difference between a CSO or a civil society organization and an NGO or the non-governmental organization? When we talk of CSOs class, or when we talk of civil society organization, it refers to different types of non-corporate, private, voluntary institutions promoting a variety of public issues. Okay. An NGO is only one form of CSO. Okay. Though often the two are taken to mean the same thing. But again, do not be confused with the term CSO and NGO. Okay. CSO, that's the wider term. No, or the broad term of an organization. Naglangkob siya tanan sa mga non-corporate private voluntary institutions. Ug mayon kag NGO, usara na siya sa form sa CSO. So, okay. Now, let's go to non-governmental organizations or NGO. Okay, so from the word non-governmental, so we can deduce that NGOs are indeed non-governmental organizations. So non-governmental voluntary associations of people and communities which work at local, regional, national, or even at international level. Now, they are organized for a mission with aims and objects of common social good. They get funding from the charities, donors, and government agencies to perform social services. Okay. Some are organized around specific issues like human rights. So naay mga NGO nga nag-focus sila on human rights. Then there are NGO nga nag-focus sa environmental issues and concerns. Then naapoy sa health, naapoy sa poverty eradication, and of course, naapoy sa employment. Okay. Let's classify NGOs. Kay daghan man kaayo ning NGO good. So let's classify them. So we have here by level of orientation and by level of operation. So first, by level of orientation, we have charitable orientation. So those NGOs na maghatag og charitable services, then service orientation, then participatory orientation, empowering orientation. Okay, when we talk of by level of operation, so we have community-based organization. So kanang atong makit-an ng mga NGO nga naa sa inyong community. So mga CBO na sila, community-based organization. We have citywide organizations. And then we also have national non-governmental organizations, and we have international non-governmental organizations. Let's proceed to types of NGOs. Okay, so first we have BINGO. BINGO is big international non-governmental organization or business-friendly international organization. So an example for this is Red Cross. So as you can see, Red Cross is not just here in the Philippines, but all over the world. No, so that's why it is considered BINGO or big international NGO. And then we have INGO, or what we call environmental NGO. So an example of that is the World Wildlife Fund. Then we have GONGO. This is governmental operated NGO. So according to its definition, it's really not an NGO, but an organization created by a government as resemble an NGO for further some agenda. Okay, then we have INGO, or international NGO. So an example for this is Amnesty International. So from the word international, makabalutanga, dili ni local NGO. Okay, then we have KUANGO, or the quasi-autonomous NGO. This is a kind of NGO which may have some part of governmental members. As its original name suggests, KUANGO is a hybrid form of organization with elements of both NGOs and public sector bodies. Now, the term is most often applied in the United Kingdom and to a lesser degree Australia and Canada. Okay, Ireland, we have New Zealand and other English-speaking countries. Now, in the UK, this term KUANGO covers different arm's length government bodies, including non-departmental public bodies. Now, non-ministerial government departments and executive agencies. So an example for this is the ISO or ISO, the International Organization for Standardization. Okay, then we have RINGO, or Religious International NGO. So for example of this is the Catholic Relief Services. Then we have other NGOs like DONGO, or Donor Organized NGO. So na-organize siya because of the donors. And then we have TANGO, Technical Assistance NGO, and MANGO, or Market Advocacy NGO. Okay. Corporate structures of NGOs. Okay, so we have here staffing. So maginhangla na siya. Staffing, funding, overhead costs, okay, monitoring and control. Now, we have here features of NGOs. Okay, so we have support democratic system. So mainly their role is to like support democratic system. It functions on no profit basis. So mo nang non-stock na siya. Then we have non-political in character. So an NGO should be non-partisan. Clearly defined objective. So dili ka pwede maghimo-himo rag imong kaugalingang NGO kung wala kay of defined objectives. Then we have limited external control. Voluntary in character. So this is voluntary, not mandatory. Then wide operational area, so daghan klaseng NGO na sa atong community. So naay mga human rights, environmental, so sa panadinha ng mga NGOs. Then we have positive contribution. So whether we like it or not, or whether we agree it or not, dako o tabang ang NGOs sa atong community. Okay. The need financial support. So kay dili man sila funded by the government, more on kuan man ni sila more on donors, no? So kinahanglan gid gihapon siya og financial support. Then interest in long-term projects. So dili lang ang usa ka NGO, dili lang nga mag-focus si Jaco og short-term project, but more on long-term. So unsa ilang ginabuhat sa community na anay long-term plan. Okay. Now, activities of NGOs. Okay, so it includes but are not limited to create awareness, no, protection of human rights, public relations, campaigning, gainful employment. Okay, so they are not limited to environmental, social advocacy, and human rights work, but they can also work to promote social or political change, no, on a broad scale or very locally. Now we have to take note, class, that NGOs play a critical part in developing society, improving communities, and promoting citizen participation. Okay. So nadere o sa atong slide, we have education, health, nutrition, youth livelihoods and child poverty, and refugee responses. Okay, functions of NGOs with respect to entrepreneurial scenario. Okay, so we have entrepreneurial development program, so EDP, counseling. Okay, this also have this function. Development of infrastructure, construction of housing facilities, supporting innovation and pilot projects, providing technical assistance. Now, let's talk about the advantages of NGO. Now, it has ability to experiment freely, flexible in adapting to local needs, okay, enjoy good rapport with people. Then we have ability to communicate at all levels, ability to recruit experts and highly motivated staff, less restrictions from the government because this is a non-governmental organization. What about its disadvantages? Okay, so lack of funds, okay, di man lagi ni sila funded by the government. Lack of dedicated leadership. So it's sad to say nga na ay mga NGOs na naapod sila ang mga naasa na natungdanan sa NGO, naapod sila ilang personal agenda. So that is the reality. Inadequate trained personnel. Okay, musulod lang uban basta raing nun nga, I am part of an NGO. No? Then misuse of funds. Okay, so this is more on sa structure na ni sa NGO. Monopolization of leadership. Lack of public participation. Then centralization in urban areas. So kasagaran to ala sa mga cities. Okay, imbis kay kinahanglan diri sa rural, no? Or sa mga geographic disadvantaged area unta. Okay? Then lack of coordination. But of course, there are other NGOs nga productive and effective in the sense. Okay, so let's talk about the roles of NGOs. So we have development and operation of infrastructure, supporting innovation, demonstration and pilot projects, facilitating communication, technical assistance and training, research monitoring and evaluation, and advocacy for poor, for and with the poor. Now, among the wide variety of roles that NGOs play, these six, now, can be identified as important at the risk of generalization. So in development and operation of infrastructure, we have community-based organizations and cooperatives. So they can acquire, subdivide, and develop land, construct housing, okay, provide infrastructure, and operate and maintain infrastructure such as wells or public toilets and solid waste collection services. They can also develop building material supply centers and other community-based economic enterprises. In many cases, they will need technical assistance or advice from governmental agencies or those high-level NGOs. Now, with regards to supporting innovation, demonstration, and pilot projects, these NGOs have the advantage of selecting particular places for innovative projects and specify in advance the length of time which they will be supporting the project, overcoming some of the shortcomings that governments face in this respect. Now, NGOs can also be pilots for larger government projects by virtue of their ability to act more quickly than the government bureaucracy. In facilitating communication class, NGOs use interpersonal methods of communication and study the right entry points whereby they gain the trust of the community they seek to benefit. They would also have a good idea of the feasibility of the projects they take up. The significance of this role of the government is that NGOs can communicate to the policy-making levels of government information about lives, the capabilities, attitudes, and cultural characteristics of people at the local level. NGOs can facilitate communication upward from people to the government and downward from the government to the people. Okay, communication upward involves government about what local people are thinking, doing, and feeling, while communication downward involves informing local people about what the government is planning and doing. Now, NGOs are also in a unique position to share information horizontally, networking between other organizations doing similar work. Okay, so manay facilitating communication. Then we have technical assistance and training. Now, training institutions and NGOs can develop technical assistance and training capacity and use this to assist both community-based organizations and of the government. For research, monitoring, and evaluation, they have innovative activities that need to be carefully documented and shared. Effective participatory monitoring would permit the sharing of results with the people themselves as well as with the project staff. Now, advocacy for and with the poor. Okay, so in some cases, NGOs become spokespersons or ombudsmen for the poor and attempt to influence government policies and programs on their behalf. This may be done through a variety of means ranging from demonstration and pilot projects to participation in public forums and the formulation of government policies and plans to publicizing research results and in case studies of the poor. Those NGOs place roles from advocates for the poor to implementers of government programs, from agitators and critics to partners and advisors, from sponsors of public projects to mediators. Okay. If you have time, class, or if you have free time, no, you just have to manage your time. You can research more on these NGOs, so you will be aware of its mission and ministry. So an example of an NGO in the Philippines is Child Hope Philippines. So i-research niya na ninyo on sending Child Hope. Okay, so thank you, and I hope you learned something from this presentation or this discussion. Okay, so I'm sorry for that. I will be uploading this video and then this task, okay, for you to do. And say you have to go out to your respective LGU or community, and then you will have to research a certain CSO or civil society organization or an NGO for that matter that is duly organized in your community and or LGU. So you just have to choose one, okay, and then you will write a presentation about it. So you will be guided on the following guide questions. So what is the name of the NGO or CSO? You have to describe its structure. What is the purpose of the said NGO? What is the contribution to your community? What is the response of the community? And what about the response of your LGU officials? And what is the overall impact of the said CSO or NGO in your community? Okay, so thank you for listening, and I hope you learned something from this discussion.